Oh, they got a ton of golf clubs. Oh my goodness. Next thrift store, and they've got some golf clubs outside. Oh, that's a Cleveland CG10. This is unbelievable. Definitely the most high-end golf store that I've ever. Oh, here's the Lady Bear's one. All right, folks, welcome back. We are headed from Whistler, Canada, out of the mountains and all the way back down into Vancouver. But we are certainly going to miss these views.
Yes.
We're gonna be doing some thrifting for golf clubs, and I don't think anything that we're gonna find today will be as beautiful as these mountains, but never know what we're gonna find though, so.
Let's go find it.
Early call on the thumbnail.
Uh-huh.
Nailed it. All right, well, those were some spectacular views. Let's see if we can find ourselves some spectacular golf clubs at our first stop, a Salvation Army, and also right across the street is a golf town, so a two for one here, but let's see if we can find some golf clubs worth picking up at the first stop. First Salvation Army in Canada. Let's see what they got.
Thank you.
Whoa. Whoa, they got a ton of golf clubs. Oh my goodness. Sporting goods section looks a little bit different than in Florida. Skis are not a hot seller. Let's see what we got in terms of the golf clubs though. Got some of the newer Tommy Armour Silverback 845 CSs.
Spalding Masters.
Got a bunch of Pinnacles, some Nancy Lopez. Got a bunch of classics in here. Doesn't look like there's anything worth picking up.
One of them is actually called Classic.
Oh, really? We got the Campbell Classic, the soup brand right there. Is also making golf clubs. Apparently got a Top Flight Prestige. Let me know if I'm missing out on these skis. I know Salomon's a really good brand, but don't know if those are gonna make the trip back to Florida with us. Yeah, we'll let you know if we find anything, but having this many golf clubs right off the bat is definitely a good sign for sure. All right, no golf clubs worth picking up at the Salvation Army, although they did have a ton of hockey sweaters.
Yes.
None of those are worth picking up, and definitely not as cool as Ashley's Happy Gilmore one, but
no.
Across the street, we not only have thrifty foods, we do have a golf town. I think this is your first golf town, right?
Yes.
I went to one 20 years ago. I don't remember it at all, and I'm pretty sure that these are owned by Dick's Sporting Goods Golf Galaxy, which we've had luck at before, but who knows what they're gonna be like in Canada. Also, who knows if you can hear me?
Other than that, though.
The leaf blowers follow us all around, but let's see what we can find at the golf town today. This place is so similar, yet very slightly different, that is kind of very interesting to us, say the least. Also, got the Canadian PGA. Teaching professionals here, which is obvious, but interesting to me. But we got a ton of clearance stuff, and I'm guessing this is where the used, oh wow, I've never even seen one of these in person. Got the Stealth Glory. These are ridiculously expensive. Also, oh, can't even get that out there.
Nope.
Let's see a price on that. $900. We're gonna be having to do some conversions,
yes.
Because Canadian dollar is a little bit different than US. But oh yeah, here's the pre-owned section over here. Let's see if there's any deals. Got the 300 mini. These are actually kind of hard to find. Become a lot more popular lately because Tommy Fleetwood is using the little mini burner 300 on the 300. If this is a 400 here, that's going to be the ultimate. Oh, this is exactly 400 Canadians with a sense of humor, probably. But let's see what we got over here. We got the D-Type M6 with the orange tensile going for 310. So that's probably about like $230 off the top of my head. We got a perfectly mint condition 2017 M1 right here. How much is that going for? We got the hazardous shaft, $260. So based on my crude math, that is about the same. Got the Dynapower, $400 on that. Not a, oh my goodness, check this out. You already know which one it is. We got the Deuce right here, a TaylorMade 200 steel, 2-wood. This have the, I think it came with the, yeah, the S90 shaft. It's only $30,
nice.
So that's like $20. That is definitely worth getting.
Oh,
200
yeah.
series is an all-time classic. You ever find the 200 Tour Series or the 300 Tour Series? Basically, every TaylorMade player used those for years. They like never upgraded until the V-Steel. But get a, oh, this is the same as the old Bluey, but just a different colorway. Our friend Rick, who we're trying to race to 3 million subscribers. He's got a little bit of a lead on us, so everybody needs to subscribe. $70 on that. That's actually a really good deal on that as well. Got a little paint chip right there on the toe. Another classic, the Ping G5 multi-compound grip stock TFC shaft.
$50?
$50 is a good deal on that. We got some super old school ones right here. I'm surprised they take these in on trades. The Big Bertha Warbird S2H2 with the bore through. It's only $10. So that's like cheaper than a thrift store. I forgot to check how much the golf clubs were at the Salvation Army, but I highly doubt that they're less expensive.
This one's $10 too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I think I saw another one over there out of the corner. Yeah, right over here, there's another one.
Okay.
Got the full setup right here.
There you go.
A full setup of fairway woods for under $30.
Yeah, that's crazy. You can get this guy.
It's a
3-for-1.
3-for-1. We talked about 2-for-1s with the stores, but we got 3-for-1s with the golf clubs. Got at Cleveland Huntington Beach, super underrated. Also super underrated, you got the Titleist H1. Oh, it's a Diamante red.
That's my current driver's shot.
Yeah, you use this in you have like the 915 and with the Diamante Reds, the like highest launching shaft that you can get. It's really good for seniors, ladies, and people hit the ball really low like me. It's got a Wind Dry Tech grip on there, only $70.
Nice.
Definitely worth it.
Adding to the collection.
Yeah, we got a Phil Mickelson grind over here, Mac Daddy wedge. We got a lower lofted SM7. The lower lofted ones tend to go for a little bit more. It's got the Tour Issue Murdered Out shaft, $140 on that. Got a Cleveland Elite going for $280, but it's not the biggest selection, but it might be the cheapest golf clubs I've ever seen at a, well, definitely the cheapest golf clubs I've ever seen at a golf town, the cheapest at a golf town affiliate, for sure. But I think we're going to get definitely the Titleist and the Deuce. I don't know if we need the 5-wood, but...
Yeah, I feel like I'd feel bad.
Yeah, you don't want to break up the set, but... There you go, a breakout performance at a golf town for us. This is definitely the coolest thing that we're gonna find all day. It's absolute grail, golden tee 3D. I think this is just like, I don't think they sell like a bunch of them. I think this is just like a used one that they happen to have.
Why
this is
they
amazing.
Have it, I don't know, but I'm so sad we cannot bring this home.
Yeah, I would play this all day, but there you go. Find of the day and a couple of finds
these
right
are still
there.
Pretty good.
Still
times.
Pretty good. All right, next stop. An SPCA thrift store apparently is right around this corner, about 200 meters away, which I have no frame of reference about how far that is. Oh, there it is. That's about how 200 meters is. Well, no golf clubs in here, but check these out. One of Callaway's first golf balls, the CXVs. A little piece of history in here. Also, the thrift store manager was hilarious. He was like, if you don't see anything you want, let me know, and if you don't like the prices, also let me know.
Yeah. We were also the third person to have asked if they have golf clubs.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't hear that one, but here you go. Callaway CXB, some classics.
Golf-related.
Golf-related. Golf light. Check these out. Also, another shout-out to the manager. He was like, we have more stuff upstairs. I was like, I didn't know there was an upstairs, but proof, we are upstairs. Also, check these out. Upstairs, some high-top Vans MT. I have the low-tops of those, and I actually play golf in them all the time because they're super comfortable, and then the tread is really good for golf.
Oh, man, these are so comfortable, but I think they're like half a size too small.
No. Dang.
Those
also
cool,
high top golf shoes. I don't know if I can pull, you can probably pull it off.
Yeah.
You're much better looking than me, but let's go see if we can find some even better deals at the next spot. Well, I think this might be the most shout outs we've ever given in one video. The manager of that thrift store, all time legend. We didn't have any, like our total bill wasn't $5, they had a $5 minimum for cards. We don't have any Canadian money. So we gave him a $5 and he gave us a $5 back on $2.
Different currency.
Yeah, you guys can tell us if that's a good deal or not. But I have no idea, but it's all the same to me.
Yes.
But let's go see if we can find some even better deals at the next spot. All right, folks, speaking of being terrible with money and shout outs, I want to give a huge shout out to the sponsor of today's video, something we use to manage our money, Rocket Money. And no, this is not a green screen.
It's real life.
This is real life. We are on the road trip still.
Yes.
And that has been made possible by the sponsor of today's video, Rocket Money. Rocket Money is an all-in-one finance platform that helps you save more and spend less. This personal finance app allows you to manage subscriptions, lower bills, and build a custom budget and grow your savings all in one place. And currently, we are using Rocket Money to help budget for this epic once-in-a-lifetime road trip. We have been able to experience some incredible things, do some incredible things.
They'll even help lower your bills by negotiating with services like cell phone and internet, because who wants to spend all day on hold?
We do love negotiating, but we do not love oh my goodness, look at this bee. That thing is crazy.
But if you want to be part of the Rocket Money crew,
you can join over 3.4 million members using Rocket Money today. I've got the hookup. Go to rocketmoney.com/stacked or click the link in the description to get started for free. You can also unlock even more features with premium. That's rocketmoney.com/stacked to get started for free. And now back to Canada.
Yes.
Hint, we're not in Canada.
No.
Although we are at a higher elevation than we were in Whistler. So stay tuned
crazy.
For the road trip. And also stay tuned for what's probably the coolest find of the day. Next thrift store, and they've got some golf clubs outside. Oh, that's a Cleveland CG10 and a Michael Jordan Jr. club. That's crazy. These were like the grails as when I was a kid. Huge MJ fan. They also came with a double-sided putter that was very similar to this, but that is super cool. Definitely going to pick up the Cleveland CG10. The bag is separate, $6 for each stick.
Oh, I like that.
Interesting, but definitely going to pick up the CG10. I remember when VJ was using the Black Pearl version of that when I was in high school. Easy way to date myself. We also got the Bob Murphy Classic, a Hall of Fame golfer, and also my favorite, different Bob Murphy, but my favorite baseball announcer of all time. Got an Orlemar Tri-Metal, a all-time classic for the as seen on TV. He's got some King Cobras, a Big Bertha. I feel like everybody had a Big Bertha here in Vancouver. We also have a mini golf putter down there and a Wilson Aggressor. That's pretty sweet. Just golf clubs sitting out here for us.
Yeah, it's
meant to be. Picked them up. There you go. Let's go see if they got anything else inside. We got a Nike golf shirt right here. Interesting.
That's cool.
That is, it's seen better days, but.
Haven't we all?
Haven't we all? But usually the Cleveland CG10s are in terrible condition when this one's actually pretty good. It's super soft metal. But let's go pick this up literally right around the corner. That was the thrift store that we were just at, and now we have another one, our second Salvation Army thrift store of the day. This one looks way bigger than the other one, so hopefully they got some bigger golf club deals than, yeah, you get what I'm saying. Ooh, 50% off. Sweet. This place is absolutely gigantic, and they have a huge sporting goods section over here with a couple of, I think those are single gear or fixed gears bikes. I used to be obsessed with these. Mm-hmm. When we were in Bloomington, I had one. Someone stole it during a Little Five, and they actually returned it broken.
That was worse.
Yeah, it was heartbreaking. Oh, I thought these were the golf clubs. Speaking of heartbreaking, but let's see if there's...
Well, there's crutches.
There's crutches. That's just like the U.S. Wherever there's crutches, there's golf clubs. Oh, there are golf clubs. What are the chances of that? That is. Oh, there's a ton of golf clubs and some hockey sticks over here. See if there's anything worth picking up. We've got a laminate. Always want to look for the persimmons that tend to go for a little bit more. Oh, we got a Super Force. I think this is by Nissan Golf. It's a Japanese brand, but still actually go... Yeah, it's not one of the more expensive Japanese brands. Some of that stuff can go for tons of money,
crazy.
But it's kind of a cool one to find. Also got a XE1 wedge right here, and as seen on TV, going for $9.99. We usually get about $35 for these on our whatnots. Got the original grip on there as well.
Arnie's own
oversize. See if there's anything else. We got a 5-wood by Daiwa. If you ever find the Daiwa irons, especially the advisors, Tiger Woods used those when he was a junior, and they have a pretty good collector's market on them. Let's see what else. Got a Ping Zing 2 knockoff back there as well. We got a golf star with
it. Junior,
yeah,
so
that's cool.
Canadian Pro.
A little Maple
future.
Leaf action on there. Got a power belt down there as well. Not the easiest clubs to see. Got a Tommy Armor 845 as well. You got a Paratone shafted Niblick, which is kind of cool. An Alien iron over there. Alien wedge, you guys are ready for it. Best selling golf club of all time. Got a Lynx. It's got a super low profile. Looks like it's missing a couple of the weights in there. A couple of screws look just like us. Oh, speaking of a couple of screws loose,
no.
That is pretty amazing right there. Snookies. Confessions of a Guidette.
There you go. A little reading for you on the way back.
Yeah, light reading.
There you go.
I don't know if the, not only one comment on the reading level, but definitely going to get ourselves a next level wedge right there, the XE1 wedge. We'll let you know if we find anything else. If we don't, we'll meet you at the next spot.
Oh, check this out. It's Pyrex.
Pyrex above the border. That
crazy
is amazing.
Daisy spring blossom.
Do you have that one?
Yeah, I have multiple of this one, but it's still really cool. We barely see these in like our thrift shops, so.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy. Florida, a lot of people just like get rid of their Pyrex before they move to Florida. So like whenever we go on like an East Coast road trip up to see my brother in Connecticut, it's just like
non-stop
Pyrex. It's
so hard for me not to buy it all.
Yeah, I don't know, we're like always afraid that we're gonna break it, so we don't buy very much of it.
It is durable, but I still don't want to test the limits.
Yeah.
Pyrex and golf clubs, still like a risky business to be in the same spot together.
Yeah, for sure. A little rattling going on right there. Don't want to see that rattle, but let's see if we can rattle some more golf clubs up.
Sometimes I try to help you, and sometimes there's no helping you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't know how you do help me.
Well,
I don't know how you keep
you
me safe.
The next spot.
Yeah, is that a pear? I thought it was an avocado. Oh, it has to have it.
It appears to be a pear.
Oh, thank you for saving me once again. Next stop, our third Salvation Army of the day, and this one looks like it is probably going to be the biggest one of the day. Hopefully, they'll have a huge selection of golf clubs for us. Let's see what they got. Oh, they got some crystals right in the. Front door. Dang, this place is huge.
Oh, wow.
All right, housewares, clothing. Let's see if there's any golf clubs. I'm assuming it's gonna be back over there. Where are we at? Home decor, bunch of camping gear. I'm thinking it's over here. Oh, there we go, a bunch of tennis rackets. they have that many tennis rackets, they might have quite, not that many golf clubs, but let's see if there's anything worth picking up over here. Got a bunch of scooters. Are these all junior clubs? Oh no, they're just angled up. No, these might be all be junior clubs. It's a treasure trove of junior clubs, to say the least.
Yes,
we got a Acer undercut sole, a Big Bertha knockoff, got a La Jolla junior club, a McGregor junior club.
Eagle Tour.
Eagle Tour. Got some U.S. Kids golf. Like a full set of these U.S. Kids golf down here.
See where the towel's from.
Hello. The golf club at Albernew. Comment below if you guys have played there before. We got a Power Distance, another U.S. Kids, another U.S. Kids. We got two U.S. Kids putters down there as well. We usually don't pick up the junior stuff, and when we do, we usually give them away for free when we sell at the flea market.
But we're a little way far away from that.
Yeah, I don't know if we're going to take these all home. I thought these were all just like at an angle. They're really all junior clubs.
I've never seen
them
before.
If you guys are in the Vancouver area and you want to hook your kid up with some good golf clubs, this is definitely the spot for you. They literally have two of the U.S. Junior Kids putters, which usually go for like, I think they usually go for like 75 to 80 bucks, but got some X14 knockoffs as well. But like I said, lifetime supply of junior clubs.
Yeah.
You have like an entire like baseball field full of kids.
There you go, you're good to go.
They're covered right here. No golf clubs worth picking up, but check this out. We were just talking about the Vids MTs. Found them in Ashley's size. How amazing is that? They fit?
Oh, I'm definitely a big fan of these.
Big fan. Oh, I see what you did there, big fan. Ashley's killing it with the pun and also with the shoes.
Snazzy shoes.
Snazzy shoes.
Right?
Awesome. There you go, we got some high top golf shoes. Like I said, Ashley can pull it off, I can't, but
hopefully could buy some high-top golf clubs.
Oh, Nailed it. You should just be the host. You are the star of the show, you should just be the host too, but we'll meet you at the next spot. Well, not only did Ashley find herself a pair of golf shoes, but I'm pretty sure these are my size Jordan golf shoes at a thrift store. That is, I have no idea how much they are or if they're my size, but that might be the coolest thing we've ever found. Definitely the coolest things we've ever found in a Canadian thrift store, but
without a doubt.
Jordan golf shoes at a thrift store. That's insane. We got to ask an associate to see if they're at my size, but that's amazing. Yeah, how freaking awesome was that? Ashley finds the MTs, and then right after that, my size Jordan golf shoes at a thrift store. That is
pretty amazing.
That's a grail if you ask me. All right, last stop of the day. We don't even have time to put on the wireless mics. Golf Town, it closes in like 8 minutes. Let's see if we can find ourselves a deal. Oh, almost got run over by a Porsche. That'd be a good way to go. But let's see if we can end things off right here.
A Porsche of a golf club.
Yeah, Porsche of a golf club. There you go. Nailed it. Oh my goodness. This is even cooler than the first Golf Town that we went to today. Check out these staff bags. We got a Strix on this one. It looks used. We got a Cobra over there by Vessel. Got some Top Golf ones. Look at all these Hanma bags. Oh my goodness. We gotta hurry, we can't get distracted by the bags. We'll see how much a Hanma bag, $500 for a golf bag. Oh, we also have some camo Strixons over here. Got the newer Nikes. Oh, and we got a Jumpman Jordan one. How cool is that? That is, all right, we gotta go find the used clubs while we still can. Man, they have like a whole, this is so cool. They have like, yeah, this is the fanciest golf store I've ever been in. Check this out, got like a sneaker store set up on the shoes over here. All the Air Max 90s, Air Max 270s.
Color.
Those are cool. All right, we're getting distracted. Oh man, these are the new Tiger Woods. It's kind of cool how Jordan releases all the retros. They're starting to release retros of the Jordans.
Huh.
That is super cool. Let's see if, I highly doubt that this place has used golf clubs based on this. Clearance. Let's go check by the putters. Got some clearance golf shoes over there. Let's see if they've got any used putters. Man. Where?
No, I'm trying to
win. Used Scotty Cameron's, yeah. I was like, where, what? Got a bunch of Odyssey chippers, ping putters. Ask staff for Scotty Cameron's. Hey, how's it going?
Oh,
awesome.
Do you guys have doing in Vancouver?
Just hanging out.
Visiting?
You guys got any used clubs?
No, not at our location.
No, okay.
Like our flagship location.
Oh, okay, so yeah, it's pretty fancy.
Expensive, stuff.
Yeah. Cool. Well, we just ran into a subscriber who works here, and apparently this location is their flagship location, so they don't really have any used clubs, but they do have some of the most expensive golf clubs that I've ever seen.
Yes.
Also, got even more Hanma bags over here. This one is $1,000. We got the full lineup of the Hanma Berets. I think these are the 7 stars or whatever the highest end one is, and look at this display thing over here. That's so cool. See how much a hybrid, look at the detail on that. Not gonna make the ball go any further, but certainly cool. $815 for a hybrid on that. Got a bunch of those, got a couple more of the Hanma bags. Man, this is just absolutely nuts. Look at the display model. It just has G4 shoes on. Yeah. It's unbelievable. Definitely the most high-end golf store that I've ever... Oh, here's the Lady Bearers ones. Those are so cool. Full-on displays. Never seen anything like that. And earlier today, I saw my first Glore Sim. Look at this. There's a whole lineup. Or the not the Sim, the Stealths. Dang. Got the burner in here. This is absolutely nuts. What else is crazy in here? Get some Sims over there. That's what made me think about it. I was seeing what I was, or talking about what I was seeing instead of, got the, I don't know what I'm talking about now, but the Azexio Primes over here, $1,200 for a three wood.
Indulge in distance.
That is nuts. But hopefully you guys did like this video. We got some Jordans. We got some pretty good golf clubs.
Pretty
also, that one with all the junior clubs, there's probably $1,000 worth of junior clubs in there. So a lot of people are like, they always say like, yeah, the thrift stores in Canada aren't great. A lot of comments, but I thought they were pretty amazing.
Yeah, a lot of fun.
Yeah, tons of fun. But hope you guys did have fun watching this video. If you did, hit like button, subscribe, and
we'll see you next time.
See you next time. 10,000 likes and we'll buy a Hanma Bearers driver.
No, we will not. False
15,000, we might do it. But I hope you guys did like this video. If you did, like button, subscribe, and
we'll see you next time.
See you next time. Thanks for watching. Also, stay tuned. Ashley hitting that the Diamana red shaft.
Yes.
I think you're gonna have a, we need to do some matches. There you go. 10,000 likes and we'll do some matches up here.
That's what I'm more willing to do instead of buying that.
Yeah, for sure. It'll be easier on our bank account. But I hope you guys did find this video easy to consume, and we'll see you next time.
Bye, guys.